You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Dean Johnson.
From the AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and Bing.com, and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's The Pauly D Project After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's The Pauly D Project After Show.
Get crazy, get wild, let's party, get loud. If you want to have fun,
do something crazy.
Wow.
All right, so what do I say, Roxy?
Hello, Bing is for doing, and we're here doing another AfterBuzz TV after show for the Pauly D Project, Season 1, Episode 1. Now you try.
No, I'm not going to do that. That was perfect.
That's
awesome. That's a wrap.
No, but then you're missing the other part. Before we do anything else.
Oh, right. What do we do?
Can you introduce yourself?
I'm introduce myself. I'm Keven Kwoww Undergaro. Doesn't everyone know that by now? And I'm here with Jessica Kingpin King, Roxy Rookie Striar, and missing... Sassy Gabby
My
Lauren.
Other matzo balls.
We're missing the other half of the matzo balls. Next two nights?
Next
no.
Next week.
She's back next back. Week and we lose you.
I know.
We lose Roxy for two Thursdays.
I'm going to New Orleans.
Oh.
Just for Mardi Gras?
No, Mardi Gras happened. I'm going just to party.
Okay, and then the week after is what?
And then the week after is, what is it? I'll think of it.
Okay.
I know I have something. Nice.
We're back. We had our drinks. We're watching the Pauly D Project.
Yes. Oh, I meant to say, because a couple weeks ago, we told our fans that if they wanted a shout out to hit us up and we'd give them a shout out.
Okay.
So we had a YouTube follower who's a loyal fan. I don't know his Twitter name, but his YouTube name is Black Pirate. So I'm assuming he's Black.
Black Pirate.
Black Pirate.
Black Pirate. Shout out, holler. And we have to give a shout out to Susie. Our loyal AfterBuzz fan. She's also a big fan of ours on Gossip Girl, and she's always the best.
And she just tweeted at us right before the show started, too.
What about Black Pirates? So there's a black fan of the Jersey Shore.
Yes, I think I'm bringing in the diversity.
I love that.
Just because the name's Black Pirate doesn't mean he's black.
No, but he's following Jessica, more than likely black. Anyway, okay, so here we
go.
Fair enough. Here we go. We're watching this. Is this our subutext to our heroine? Is this?
Can you reword that?
Okay,
I totally understood you.
Okay, but for the fans, maybe you can translate. So
basically, Jersey Shore being our heroine.
It's okay. Guilty pleasure.
Well, I would prefer to call it like Coke and Diet Coke, so like Adderall or something. You know, that's like our big, the boss of our guilty pleasure, and this is a little.
No, it's heroin. You know? We have our heroin. We come in. We love it. We escape to another world with the Jersey Shore. And now we want to hold ourselves over until Jersey Shore comes back.
So what would that be?
Subutext.
But what
or
if
methadone.
This
or methadone.
Being...
This is us okay. going to methadone clinic.
What is it if it becomes better than Jersey Shore? So then
it's horse. What's better than heroin?
Yeah.
I was sort of thinking, in my opinion, it may be better, but you guys have experienced it and watched it more than I have. I feel like I'm going to like it more because it's evolved.
Here's why for me, it's not going to be, it's going to be subutext because it's different and it could be better. But for what we love the shore, we love to party, we love to like watch the show, we mm-hmm. love to laugh with them, laugh at them. This to me is, it seems more real. It seems.
I like that.
I do too. But is it? Is it really more of an escape for us?
And I feel like this is a perfect time to say better or worse. You tell us. What do you like? On our iTunes page, we want the comments. We want the comments.
Good segue.
And no, it's true. And we want the ratings. Everyone has different tastes. You know, are you tired of Jersey Shore? Can you not wait? Like Kevin's saying, you're waiting for the next season, season 6. Does this just hold us over? Please comment on our iTunes page. Rate us. Literally, like, we work our asses off for you guys here at AfterBuzz. Like, we work very, very hard.
And we're glad to do it.
because we love you guys.
We just want one favor back. You know, hit us up. That's it. Like, show us love. That's it.
And tell a friend.
Okay,
tell a friend about us.
Tell two friends. Yes.
Here's my thing. And here's why I'm kind of on page Ronnie, team Ronnie over here. Because honestly, I'm really into this whole DJ craze right now. And I go and I see all my favorite DJs and I travel around and I follow them. And, you know, I've got my Afrojack, my Avicii, my A-Track, my Swedish House. I'm a huge DJ fan. I love the house music. And I know there are all these negative connotations that go along with it. And people have judgments and biases against it. But honestly, I think if you have a talented DJ, it's just as talented as having a talented musical artist.
No, I know, but we
like,
can't.
People wanted to see Entourage, you know, which was a scripted show for their lives. And I feel like now we have a show, a reality show, that's going to kind of give these guys
lives.
Well,
it's just very current.
That's what and we've finally broken down the fourth wall.
Which is what we've been asking for.
One of you
so
guys
long.
Had mentioned, you know, Pauly had a quote where he acknowledged, you know, the Jersey Shore made me.
It was the first quote of the show, and he said, Jersey Shore made me famous, exactly. And I was like, boom, right away, I know the show is going to be great. Because if he's sitting there and he's acknowledging, look, for the first time ever, yeah, I am famous. He's never said that on the Jersey Shore. They've never allowed him to say that, or any of the other cast members. And as long as he's admitting that, as long as we're seeing these hot girls come back to his place, his entourage and him saying, I'm glad I could take my boys out for the ride with me. That's awesome. That's
by the way, how revealing that his wingman, which we'll get into all the characters later, but his wingman brings back a beautiful girl,
right.
Probably hotter than anything
super
we've ever
pretty,
seen
yeah.
come home at the Jersey Shore. Question to both of you. Is that because the quality of girls are better in Vegas, or because we've broken down this fourth wall and we're showing that they're rock stars and they're getting rock star tail?
I think they're finally showing it.
You know what? I think it's a mix of both, but I'm a little confused, and here's why. In tonight's episode, we see that there's a six-month gap, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm curious about is the last season of Jersey Shore they filmed ended beginning of September. They ended filming. Now, if we got 6 months from the beginning of September, October, November, December, January, February, March, that's what month we're in right now. So were they filming this originally when they were also filming Jersey Shore? Do you know what I mean?
Which is also weird to me also because I remember hearing, obviously, it was all over the press when Pauly got offered the residency at the Palms, but I don't remember ever hearing about his one night there. And I feel like even though it was for the show and whatnot, it would have leaked and everyone would have known, you know, Pauly D is spinning at the Palms tonight, like catch him in Vegas or whatnot. And so I was kind of wondering about that whole 6 month period and I mean, because they made it seem like he just didn't do anything, and I'm sure that's not the case. Like, they made it seem like they were just sitting there waiting for that call.
Yeah, they were all sitting there except for Jerry, who was running
yeah
there.
And losing weight
and losing weight and
I also
not sitting there.
Was wanted to mention this episode, like, dove into it so quickly.
Right.
30 seconds into the episode, he was getting a call from his manager about the Palms. So it was weird to me how, I mean, I know it's only 30 minutes and who knows.
It's 30 minutes, so they have less time. And remember, it's almost like in filmmaking, it's your inciting incident.
Yeah.
Because we're going to learn, and we were surprised, we're going to learn that J-Rock is actually a regular on this.
Yeah.
So it's the show is essentially what we're going to learn. What we learn is this is like a pilot. It's like a first episode. It's the setup. And the setup is for the cast to be in Vegas working at the Palms.
Right.
So that's why they jumped right into it as fast as they did.
I thought it was a really strange setup, and I've got a couple things to say on that. Number one, honestly, this sounds ridiculous, but I felt really dizzy during this entire thing. And you mentioned it during the episode, and I couldn't tell why, but you put the nail on the head for me, and you put the finger on the dot, whatever you want to call it. You were like, is this really blurry to everybody else?
The camera quality seemed less than what we see on Jersey Shore. And
Which is already pretty bad.
Yes.
I mean, granted, we
less.
Were drinking during this episode,
but
so I was like,
But I checked, other stations, and on the commercial breaks, our projector, everything was fine.
Exactly.
It's like, I don't know if they're not using HD cameras or something. It's just weird.
Trying
to
save money. So
yeah.
On combining what you guys are saying, number one, they jumped so fast into it that I just felt like, holy crap, what did I just get myself into? And number two, the camera quality sucked. So I was like, now I'm in this like bumpy roller coaster and I'm a little confused. That being said, I'm really excited for the rest of this ride. But tonight's episode, I think they could have done a better intro. And maybe I'm the only person out there in America who couldn't tell Biggie and Jerry apart.
You were struggling with that.
I was struggling.
For sure.
I was like, Jesus
Jerry
Christ.
Jerry is clean shaven, bald, and the other one has
Biggie has hair. Yeah, but Roxy first, could not for the entire 30 minutes. She's like, Jerry, no, that's Biggie. No, that's Jerry.
We're gonna get into all the characters, smaller.
But we'll get into the characters. But just for final thoughts on just on you know our like culture shock of just seeing the show, I did notice in the credits, Larry Rudolph is actually one of the producers. Larry is Britney Spears' longtime producer, manager. So that's interesting that they're working together. Sally Salsana, of course, is concept developed by, so she's still got her hooks in this from Jersey Shore.
Right, but Kev, I have to pick your brain about this because you're in this business and you know it so well, and I am still confused, and I want answers to my question of what the hell is a six-month gap? When were they filming?
I think that, I hope I don't like spoil anything for anybody, but I feel like his like little tryout wasn't a tryout. I think they knew that he was going to go there. Yeah, and they probably set that up. And that's something that could be shot a couple of days when he came home from the Jersey Shore, even before he went to Italy. You could shoot something like that.
He could have even left and like for 100%. A Saturday night or something.
Yes.
And gone and done it.
Done it. Come back without missing a beat. So that's what I think happened. And then in that 6 months, he was filming and doing what he normally did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it also wouldn't make sense that they would just film that one night and then 6 months would go by. You know, they knew to film that and then 6 months would go by and they're like, oh, well, good thing we got that on tape or something like that, you know?
I like the idea as when the girlfriend came in.
Wait, well, I have to, I'm kind of nervous. It smells like burning rubber.
It does.
In here.
I was going
to
say something too. You know what it is, Ronnie? Is the heat on?
I will get that all checked out for you.
I was going to like mention it during the commercial break.
All of a sudden, like I was burning. Not going to say anything on air, and then I was like, our fans deserve to know that I'm looking weird.
It was just
I'm
a matter of time. You know what? I want you guys, I'm going to go like put the fire out, whatever it is. But can you guys talk about, for me, why I think the show is going to be good? It's just going to be good in a different way. I like when the girlfriend came in. And they had to break the news to her. Oh, geez, I'm sorry. This is really bad.
I don't think
this
we
is
got
bad
it.
That we don't
girlfriend.
Know.
She's
I'm really
the only
sorry.
Girlfriend on the show.
She's, I don't think
we'll
got
have
it.
Her name.
Biggie's
everyone, please don't be down.
Let
us first. We go up 10 minutes after the show. We'll know next week. But I like that she was a cute girl. She's
really cute.
Really sweet. And for her to come in and that like moment for me is like the show settled down. It was so fast music, this, that, that. And I was like, oh my God, this will make us nauseous if we do 12 episodes of this. But when we see it slow down at the end, mm-hmm. it was like, okay, here we go. We're settling in. So
I
really
the fact
enjoyed that.
She just comes in and hangs out. She's like one of the boys. You could tell the level of respect that they all have for her.
I'm still trying to look this up, but I'm listening.
No, I just thought it was a great moment to show, you know, her with her boyfriend.
But I have to ask the obvious question. Wait, sorry, I suck at this. The boyfriend is Jerry.
Biggie. Biggie has hair. Jerry's bald.
Okay, so her boyfriend, Biggie, it's the obvious question, but...
What does she see in him?
I mean, is he just the greatest guy? How long have they been dating?
Maybe
does she know
sweetheart.
He's Pauly's best friend?
He seems like a sweetheart, and maybe, I don't know, it could be one of those things, like I'm hoping that later in the episode they'll dive more into the relationship and how it came about and how long they've been dating. We saw in previews for the season that he's going to propose. So maybe it's
I think it's a long time,
sort of
it's a long time
where
girlfriend
they've been
dating
and since, you know,
it
high
seems like a long time girlfriend. Well, listen, we're going to talk about all of them.
Is the fire out?
It's out. Let's jump right into to Biggie. Let's jump into Biggie.
Yes.
So Biggie, from our research, is Pauly's mentor. He's also a DJ.
DJ Biggie
together.
And he kind of manages him. Mm-hmm. Like we know, there's an Adam who calls in and probably does the high end managing, but maybe he's like the road manager.
Okay.
And
they also call him MJ.
He's gonna be. It seems like he's the straight one of the group, meaning the straight guy who's not gonna be crazy, indulging in the womanizing. His parents have a nice house. Love the whole Italian thing of still living at home, mm-hmm. which is just huge. Myself, I went back into
is he Italian?
I think
his
into my 30s.
I'm going to say this is so confusing because now I'm on the Wikipedia page and we've got Pauly's name is not Pauly D and there's Michael Morgan and there's Gerard Gilani.
I'm saying this. Here's what
Ryan
I'm saying.
Ryan Lobby, Jason
Probably Italian,
Craig.
Irish.
Who are these people?
I'll find out. Everyone back up.
Oh my God, I'm freaking out. Right.
Rewind.
I think seeing Biggie, this is going to be a great contrast. He's got a beautiful girlfriend who seems very sweet. I think he genuinely loves her. And I love the idea that he has to, he's the one, and what they're saying on the MTV website is he's kind of the one that holds it all together.
That's got to be
he's
tough.
Cleaning up the messes
in that lifestyle, especially with them all in Vegas.
Very hard.
Partying, hooking up with girls, and he, you know, I mean, I give him props for him wanting to be faithful, because when he said that seeing them all party makes him miss his girlfriend even more, I thought he was going to say it makes him want, you know, to party too,
yeah, no,
right,
or something like that.
How sweet is he? For me to see him cry over Pauly's success.
Yeah. He had such beautiful
eyes.
I
thought that was really nice.
See, Biggie has the pretty eyes. That's what I was trying to differentiate.
But didn't you think it was a great moment, like that he was so proud of him? He said it's like a parent watching his kid succeed like
so
that.
So cute.
I love it. I think it's very genuine.
Is he older?
I would gather he might be older.
I love on this show that, you know, Pauly never lost sight of the entourage and the team. Like, everything that he says is our. He doesn't say my. Like, he made a comment where he was like, our dream is finally coming true. So it's very like a shared dream and lifestyle that he has, because he has so much love for these guys.
And still living at home with the dad.
Yeah. Rather than, you know, him being like, I'm famous, I'm too good for this, like whatever. And I really respect that about him.
And would you do you think maybe situation wouldn't be like that?
Oh, definitely not.
Why didn't we see any of these guys on the Jersey Shore? You know, we saw the unit. By the way, we actually saw the unit. But we saw the unit. We saw Ryder. We've seen a bunch of these. We saw Dina before she was on the show. Why haven't we seen any Pauly's friends? Or these ones?
I don't know. I mean, that's he just seems like he's such a healthy person. Like, out of all of them, he seems the healthiest. Like, where he'd know, yeah, I'm not, I don't want to mix camps. I don't want, like, I'd be unhealthy. I'd bring everyone in like an idiot.
And he did, Pauly this morning, I mean, he's been doing a ton of press all day today, and this morning he DJed for Good Morning America for the entire, like, 2 or 3 hours that they're on, and then they did an interview with him, and he made a good distinction, because they're like, tell us the difference, you know, other than the fact that this is following your life and you're DJing, tell us the difference between this and Jersey Shore, and he's like, well, Jersey Shore is strangers that became friends, and this is, like, my true friends, my real friends.
Wow.
And so he probably just wanted to make sure, you know, that nothing comes in the way of that, like, because he knew that Jersey Shore was just going to be like a big party and, you know, just for television.
Let's talk about Jerry. We see a rapid weight loss with Jerry.
Yes. We have more about that in News and Gossip.
Yeah. And he's security. I don't think he's going to be getting
now
many
he's
girls.
He's smaller and he's still going to be the security.
Yeah, allegedly. So
Gerald
will be fun.
See, he's Italian.
Yeah.
Giallinella.
What about
Wait,
the fact?
Hold on. Jerry was the cock block tonight.
Yes. Yeah.
Why can't I get this?
I don't know.
Yeah. So what
You'll
the hell, Jerry? Stop being such a cock block.
Oh, come on. That's what he's going to do.
Why?
Because guys like that television. Don't get the girls.
Ryan,
that,
the little hottie, is in there with another hottie.
Well,
and Jerry's like,
why would
guitar.
That girl just leave? Like, I would have thought that was funny and be like, oh, your friend's funny. But, I mean, if you're into the guy, you wouldn't just be like, peace.
Oh, who knows if she left. All the That's way left. True. But, so, Ryan, let's talk Ryan. He's the social director.
And the social
cute.
Director. I love how Pauly
and
has
he's
made
the wingman.
Official titles for each of his guys.
So he seems like the best friend.
I see, yeah, he's the best friend, and I see Ryan being the other stud of the show.
Yeah.
He was a cutie, he had personality, and clearly he doesn't have an actual job with them.
No.
He's not the body guy, he's not the other DJ. He's the guy who...
He looks hot right there, look at that.
Yeah, Pauly got to bring one best friend along, and this was the guy.
This is the guy that they promised, you know. If anything happens...
And it says, Ryan Lab... Here comes trouble. Ryan is the guy responsible for bringing their group together as club manager for Ultra, where he gave Pauly and Biggie their first gigs.
Oh,
so how about that?
So it seems like Biggie is like the longtime childhood friend, maybe, and maybe the rest of them kind of came along throughout the ride.
Well, Ryan probably gave him his break at Ultra.
Mm-hmm. We gather tonight. Ultra is the biggest club in Rhode Island.
Yes,
I guess. I mean, that's where, you know, and
in all of Rhode Island, that huge state.
And what do you guys do? You know, we back up a little bit. How nice was it to Pauly living with his dad?
That's
so
cute.
Great.
It's
not,
sad that his
and
dad.
Smart, but smart too. Not taking, if it's true, not taking, let's say, the money, putting a down payment on a big house that maybe in 5 or 10 years he can't afford.
Mm-hmm.
Just living with his dad because he's on the road all the time. Like, why not?
Yeah. I mean, where is he going to have a house anyway? He's always moving around. But this part of the episode actually really upset me. And we skipped over really fast because I don't think MTV wanted to get too bogged down in it. But his dad looked like crap, to be honest. Like, you saw his dad, right?
Yeah, he
I don't mean that meanly. I mean it honestly. Like, if I were Pauly, and you could actually see him, Pauly, and this is the part that I love about him, he was actually concerned.
He was.
And when Pauly went out into DJ, he was actually nervous. And leaving his dad, he was actually concerned. And these are real emotions because this is a completely new experience for him.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing because this is why he's been able, I mean, he's been so successful, I think. And that's why he's going to continue to be successful. But he's just not let, this has not affected him. It's like it's affected the rest of the cast. Yeah. It seems like
he's still Pauly.
Even like, it's even affected Snooki in a different way.
Sure. Oh, absolutely.
And he's just like, I am who I am. I'm very set and I'm sturdy. These are my feet are planted and I feel grounded. And these are my roots. And this is my talent and I'm going to take it and I'm going to run with it.
He even said that as he was DJing tonight at Ultra. He's like, I'll never forget where I came from. And everyone went like, the crowd went crazy. Went crazy.
Crazy.
That shit cray.
That shit cray cray. And then, of course, J Rock, we were able to just see him briefly in Vegas.
A regular cast member now.
Now he runs the Palms, I
J-Rock
guess, or has a high position at the Palms.
J-Rock got Pauly
elite circle,
and he got Pauly the gig.
Known as Mr. Vegas, which something tells me that title's been handed out once too many times.
And what I was
a lot of Mr.
Is,
Vegas is running around.
J-Rock
lot
is
dead
thanking
too.
His lucky stars right now that one day he was like, I have this idea to call up Pauly, and I'm going to get him this job. Somehow hooked it up hardcore. Not that that'd be that difficult. Anybody would love Pauly to DJ there. By the way, Pauly, who's getting $40,000 a night to DJ at the Palms. So no pocket change.
I was just reading his little thing, and it said that he currently works at Hyde. So that's interesting that he's promoting Palms on this show right now, because it said that he currently works at Hyde Bellagio.
All those clubs,
unless
I feel like, are so
left.
Intertwined.
Maybe intertwined, or maybe he's left. Well, they might be under the same ownership. I don't know. We should know better.
Yeah,
let's find out next week.
Let's take a trip to Vegas.
I don't think the Maloofs own the Bellagio.
No.
From what
whatever
I've gathered,
it is,
I don't know.
J-Rock just hit the jackpot.
We do have one of the hosts of SmackDown is friends with one of the producers of this show. Of the AfterBuzz SmackDown show.
Oh, right.
And so let's get all these questions
down.
Together. Yes.
We went out to lunch and drinks with him the other day. We're schmoozing him. He was spilling his guts.
We also bumped into the unit at a party at the Dancing with the Stars AfterBuzz TV after party. And believe me, and if you're watching Dancing with the Stars, or if you're not, please do watch and please vote for Maria to keep AfterBuzz on the air. Needless to say,
she's got to make money for us to keep going.
Yes. Or as I'm saying, just stay distracted long enough so we can keep spending money without her knowing. Anyway, we were at the party, and who shows up but the unit? And it turns out he lives nearby.
Right.
He wants to come into AfterBuzz.
I had no idea he was living in L.A.
With his little
That's
Guido
so
girlfriend. He was like, mm-hmm. Yeah. And I was like, go girl.
Yes.
You got an attitude.
And he was telling us he's season 6. He doesn't know if he'll be involved or not. He's waiting to hear if Mike's going to be better. He said he's just kind of keeping a safe distance, waiting for the phone to ring. He's not pushing the subject. I was telling him I love him on the show. Hopefully we see more of him.
But if you want my opinion, and I also love him on the show, in person he seems a little different, like a really nice, genuine guy, not very tan, not very GTL oriented at all. Just saying.
Yeah.
I thought so.
I'm still shocked that he picked up and moved to L.A.
It's just different. But, Roxy, you go into a party like that. We have had the most elite people in television.
That's
at
true.
That party.
And that was a compliment to him. I thought he was
so
great
and
on his best behavior.
He's going to tone it down. When he's down at the shore, I'm sure it's different.
Right. That's true.
So,
true.
Anyway, let's go to a commercial. And I know we have a lot of news and gossip. And then we're going to go over our future thoughts about this show. Will it last? Where's it going to go?
It's only a half an hour show, so I guess our after show is going to be longer than the actual show.
Maybe, maybe, or maybe not.
We have a lot to say.
Let's go to commercial.
AfterBuzz TV.
Hi, I was once like you, a lazy, angry loner whose only joy was watching TV and surfing the net. And like you, after I'd see one of my favorite TV shows, I'd be so excited and have so many questions that I'd actually have to talk to my douchebag coworkers about it at the water cooler. Then I discovered AfterBuzzTV.com. AfterBuzz TV produces after-show webcasts and podcasts for TV series of all kinds. like post-game wrap-up shows for all your favorite TV shows. AfterBuzz TV hosts are industry insiders who break down episodes of shows, take calls from fans, and interview cast and crew from each series, with over 60 different aftershows, from Boardwalk Empire, to American Idol, to Vampire Diaries, to Real Housewives, and more. Now, after a night of TV, I can ignore my stupid coworkers, who I hate, and go straight to my desk and watch or listen to all my favorite AfterBuzz TV aftershows and have all the TV fan interaction I need. Thank you, AfterBuzz TV.
AfterBuzz TV, what do you want to buzz about?
Bzz. All right, let's go to news and gossip.
Why are we whispering?
I don't know.
Sounds good. DJ Pauly D.
Yeah. AfterBuzz News. Hey, Ronnie. Wake up, Ronnie.
Can we have Jesse?
I was actually going to play a song that...
Ronnie. Yes. I have a question for you, Mr. Radio Man, hipster doofus that you are. What does the title MJ mean?
MJ?
Yes.
They call Biggie MJ.
MJ Biggie. He's not DJ Biggie. He's MJ Biggie. Is it Master Jockey? Is it because he's like...
Instead of MC.
Guys, calling me.
He's a sensei. Rocks.
I don't know the answer to that, what I do know is that Susie just tweeted at us saying that her name is Mary Jane Giampa. Oh. The girlfriend. So MJ, Mary Jane.
Mary Jane Giampa.
Thanks, Susie.
Little Guidette, what's up? Thank you, Susie.
And not only that, but I have a request. I want to put a request in with our very own DJ here, our resident DJ, DJ Jesse Janity, to come in and talk to us about DJing and what it takes to make a set. And Paul was saying he's preparing, and I don't even know what that means. So
I know what it means.
I just want...
Who cares?
Let's go to news and gossip.
They don't care. They want to know about Pauly. Find out from your fans if they care. We'll do it.
Speaking of that, I think they want to
see Gabby dance.
At the Palms,
that's true.
When he was DJing and the speakers went out, did like none of the club goers or whatever care that they couldn't hear the music?
They're all rolling. And there was some music playing, so they were fine. Please, news and gossip.
Assumptions about the rolling.
All right, Ronnie, I'm going to come in there and do the news and gossip.
I'm going to tell you that the little technical board ain't working, so if you guys just want to get to the news. Yeah, make it up.
AfterBuzz.
No, news and gossip. Wait, what's our news and gossip plug?
I don't know.
I just had it in my head, and then you got it out of my head because you put that weird song in there.
Anyway, okay, let's go.
AfterBuzz news and gossip.
No, that's not it.
AfterBuzz TV news.
We can try it one last time. Here we go. Let's try it one more time.
AfterBuzz TV news.
You knew it.
Oh, there you go. Well, 50 Cent, 50. Got some unusual help for his first Street King energy drink commercial. The mogul and rapper recruited Pauly D and comedy legend Joan Rivers to help spread the gospel of the newest beverage on the block. The trio gathered at Planet Fitness in Upper Manhattan to promote Street King. Getting Rivers and Pauly on board was all in the rapper's master plan to get everyone interested in what he's selling. Fitty says, quote, "It's exciting. I got Joan Rivers here. I got Pauly D, a real oddball group. We felt like it would hit different targeted audiences."
Very interesting.
Yes, indeed.
I love Fitty.
Well, unlike Angelina, who last week said that Mike's drug problem was obvious, Pauly D says he was in the dark. He tells MTV, quote, "I don't know too much about it. I didn't know he had a problem until I heard it in the media, so I wish him the best. I support him. I hope he gets well because I want him to film season 6. Pauly D also told GMA this morning that Vinny will make an appearance in his new show, The Pauly D Project, because they can't live without each other. But things got awkward when Laura Spencer asked, "Well, what about Mike? Will we see him?" Pauly's answer, no.
Guys, he says, "I didn't know Mike had a problem." I think that's his polite way of saying, "I knew he was using drugs, but I didn't know it had gotten that far."
I didn't want to recognize it.
Exactly. And what we had been saying all along is that they're just not close anymore.
Yeah. We also did an interview with him today at E, and when we asked about Mike, he said, "He's weird, but he's a nice guy."
Because you work at E, which might have been confusing.
Sorry.
Now.
According to TMZ, Pauly D feared for his safety earlier this week during a gig in South Padre Island, and extra security along with local police had to be called to control the massive crowd. Apparently, Pauly's team was worried that the venue, Louis' backyard, was not properly equipped to handle the crowd, and Pauly D was assured extra security would be brought in to help out. According to their sources, the stage Pauly D performed on was supposed to have a few feet of room between it and the fans, but that didn't happen, and the stage became surrounded, with fans even trying to climb on the stage. Pauly D had to be escorted out by 15 security and police, and still ended up getting his shirt ripped off by the mob of fans.
Yikes.
Scary. So scary.
But that's exactly what we're asking for, to break down that fourth wall.
Break down that fourth wall.
We're going to start seeing a little more of that right on the show.
Still scary. I feel bad for him or any. I mean, celebrities are asking for it. But
you don't want to lose your life at the end of the day.
Exactly. You want to be popular, as you tell Maria.
Yeah, you were the one who wanted to be popular.
Exactly.
The fact that, like, Pauly D's, like, a big guy, like, he could obviously defend himself. He's not, like, a girl or whatnot, and he has to be escorted out by 15
When it's a mob, nobody can defend himself.
Nobody's that big.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's, like, not crazy to think about it. No. Now, we've all been talking about Jerry, the bald one.
Point him out.
It's obvious, you know, we were introduced to him tonight, bald guy. And it was obvious throughout the episode that he has lost a ton of weight.
In photos I'm seeing, he's lost even more than what we saw at the end.
You wouldn't even recognize him. First, I thought he was Biggie. Now he's Jerry, and now he's Skinny Jerry. I'm so freaking confused.
He was huge, and he lost major LBs. We did, again, I work at E! We did an interview with him and Pauly, and he says, since the first episode was shot, which we saw tonight, he was 400 pounds. And since then, he's lost 160 pounds. He went down from 400 to 240.
Does he want to continue losing weight?
I think so. He says Pauly's been kicking his ass at the gym, and they're going hard at it. And
he looks great in this
picture. He's working
really
hard. So congrats to him. He looks amazing, especially for when he had his shirt off at the pool in the episode tonight.
I give him credit. I bet you anything, he knew he was going to be on TV. He knew he was going to be in the spotlight. And he did something about
it. But I love that.
400 pounds, I did too. That's crazy.
That's amazing.
That's great. I mean, if you know you're heading in the right direction and you're like, I got to get in shape, kick your butt and do it. And he did.
In today's world, let's not rule out lap band or stomach stapling.
But he lost so much. Or gastric bypass. 60 pounds is amazing.
Don't rule that out in today's day and age.
That's the truth.
Truth.
Well, that's all we have today for our AfterBuzz news and gossip.
Let's go into predictions.
Okay, I got a list of things that we're seeing this season. Want to hear it?
And now, your AfterBuzz.
Do you want to hear it?
Yes.
Starting with the race car, whatever the hell that was. Then we're moving on to Biggie's girlfriend. We see the proposal.
Let's go.
Yes.
We see Ryan. I don't know what the
Ryan says. Walks out at
oh,
some
walks
point.
Walks out. Please. Yeah, exactly. Pauly. Breakfast. I can't even read my own writing.
Breakfast with breakfast. The girl.
Yeah, that's a big, big step.
Breakfast.
Breakfast. He also DJs his own prom. We see him getting his nails done by his ex-girlfriend,
which I love.
He doesn't consider his ex-girlfriend,
but he's genuinely friends with her.
He
though
he thought that he dated for 5 months, and she said 7 years.
Right. He opens for Britney. And
such a guy, and still went back to be friends. I love that.
Yeah, that's what we great. See. That was the season.
And Britney, and we saw no shots of Britney.
It's Britney, bitch.
We did see the shot of him on the stage.
Him on the stage.
With her when she puts
but
the
bow shot, on. The shot of the shot. Like it was a shot of the big Tron, the big whatever they call it.
So we'll see Britney Tron. Are we excited for the season?
I am. I think it's going to, I think it has a lot to offer. The scenes for the season look interesting. So I'm going to give it a chance and hope that we get a lot more information than we did tonight.
Okay.
What about you?
Yeah, I'm fucking stoked.
Really?
Yeah, I think it's going to be amazing. Honestly, I think it's going to be great.
Better than Jersey Shore?
For sure.
Jersey Shore season 5? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
And
what about
four,
you?
And 3.
Really?
No, and 4 and
no,
2.
Wait,
can I ask you guys
great.
Something?
Yeah,
why is it better? Why is it going to be better, do you
because
think?
Because I think DJing is a huge thing right now, and everybody loves Pauly D. He's their favorite character. It's like if they did a good
job on
the Joey
Why do you like
spin-off.
It better? I'm not asking about the
I
audience.
I think that
why do you
of
like
all
it
the
better?
Jersey Shore, like we know, we've already pointed out our favorites from all the Jersey Shore. I think Pauly D is the most real. I don't think we're going to be sitting here 50% of the time like we do with Jersey Shore trying to figure out what's dick in the soup and what's fake and what was planted and whatnot. I think that they're just a real group of friends who are having a good time, who have each other's back, and are just trying to like live their dream. And
I feel like Pauly is the only one this whole time that didn't try too hard. You know, a lot of them maybe didn't have something to back up. You know, if you're a DJ, you could back yourself up by having a DJ career.
Yeah.
So the other people, you know, Dina, I mean, no, I'm not singling her out, but maybe she has to lay on a really good television performance, and that's maybe the difference. He's natural, and that's what we want to see. And then going off what Roxy said, the DJ community, I mean, that's like a big deal as well. The Vici, I love, you know, I mean, it's just, yeah, so.
I love music. I think this is going to combine the two worlds, and also, it's 30 minutes is an easy watch. It's like our new Entourage, and honestly, having Entourage not be on the air is devastating. I would love this to have taken the Sunday night spot.
And for those of us that, you know, that do love house music and love all the DJs out there right now, you know, I personally haven't had a chance to listen to Pauly's music, so I think it'll be interesting to see, like, how he performs and how he is in front of a crowd, because maybe I'll want to go to the Palms this summer and go wherever he's DJing at.
Oh, yeah. Actually, now I think he's a resident at Vanity, but yeah.
Well, he's doing like rehab.
I'm going to just let this much dead air go by and see when Ronnie has the instinct to roll the music. Come on,
there's
Ronnie.
No dead air. We're on it. You're hating on the show right now.
No, wait a second. Okay. No.
Start you didn't with, even where say
we,
your.
Where can we find you? How do we get to you?
At Undergaro. You can find me there. And what about you?
Do you like the show? Do you think it's going to do
Oh,
well?
My thoughts? I do like the show a lot. I love Pauly. I'm happy we keep it going. I'm already nervous that in 12 weeks, we're going to be without anything until like late in the summer. So I'm very concerned about that.
Well, 12 weeks, it's going to be summer almost.
We just have to enjoy this. Yeah. No, I think I'm going to enjoy it a lot. I agree with everything you guys are saying. I think but it's not going to be Jersey Shore. It's definitely something different. It's more real.
If you're expecting Jersey Shore, you're going to be
let
down.
It's not the insanity of Jersey Shore. Yeah. And I had a lot of people, Florence Henderson had mentioned she wanted to come in and do the Jersey Shore with us.
Nice.
We know Unit. Yeah, but you know what? I'm thinking I'm going to hold them back and bring them in for Jersey Shore because this isn't...
It's too new. It's too new.
No, and it's too normal in a way. I want her to face the insanity. That's the fun of the Jersey Shore. Anyway, I'm on board.
We'll
I'm in.
See you
in
weeks
I'm
to
in.
Come.
And it'll be interesting to see what Gabby says too.
Yeah.
We miss Gabby.
We miss her. She's coming back next Matt's week. Well.
Bye, guys. What
From
about you guys?
Bing.com, executive producers Maria Menounos, Keven Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later, bitches.
Bitches.
Questions expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.